forgot this recording option. Sir has reminded me, but I try to excuse me that I forgot to switch on the record button. Anyway, now it is now recording. Recording is on. So we try to avoid this www. It is now suppressed. Suppressed in the sense that it is not having any meaning. In the olden days, where keep all their web resources in a particular folder. That folder name is basically your www. In other terms, it can be a subdomain also. So in an organization where they would like to keep all their web resources at one particular place, that subdomain name, usually they term it as www. Nowadays, that has not got any meaning, specific purpose. So it has been changed to corresponding HTTP or your HTTPS if the website is maintaining the HTTPS. Right. Now coming to one question which Arun Dharava. So before going to the Arun Dharava, there is another student actually. Let me just open that. I forgot that question actually. Assignment one resubmissions, please try to avoid as much as you can. If the worst case, please let us know by email so that we keep record of those things. So there is no resubmissions of assignments. You're not given that option. So you need to be very careful before submission of your assignments. So Pavan Kumar, I am not able to Ubuntu software. What is this? Sir, I am not able to Ubuntu software in Windows 10 laptop.
I think probably he is not able to install it. He wants that virtual machine video.
Virtual box.
Virtual box video.
Yes, my videos are there. That's what I told him. But if you open to my channel, there I have installed Ubuntu on the virtual box itself, and as well as the LAMP stack. So that LAMP stack installation also is a video recording has been done. That will be useful for you in the coming weeks. But for to install the Ubuntu software, it is very a simple process, straightforward. You can see my video. Just type my name and my video is there. You can follow my steps, or you can get it from the Ubuntu website itself. So Ubuntu can be downloaded from the website of the Ubuntu website itself. So if you go to Ubuntu, let me open and show for those people who are having some difficulty to where to get the Ubuntu software. Yeah. Ubuntu, the latest version is 20.04 LTS. So you can, the release is .ubuntu.com. The server name, they call it as FocalFISA. So always please have a right side viewing of the contents, what exactly is taking place by the website. So my internet bandwidth is very slow. That's why you are not getting the data contents very, the graphics, the images that are not getting properly rendered onto my web page. Okay, anyway, so you have a desktop image as well as a server. As a student, if you are a beginner, please install the server in images so that you practice the command line arguments. Desktop images will have GUI, graphical user interfaces. So I prefer to for you to install server images and start practicing the commands on the command shell prompt. That we call it as a shell prompt, not a command prompt, but a shell prompt. So there are so many sources are there here. So you can, there are torrent files are also there, ISO. So you can install the .iso file onto your virtual box, and the virtual box will take care of the installation for you. It may take not more than 15 minutes of your time. Of course, the internet bandwidth speed has also been to be considered. So that is what Pawan, I think Pawan is not there, but for those people who have attending, for them it will be useful. Now coming to Arun, anyway, he's not coming, but let him see this video if he is able to see it in the later stage. Arun Dauti is basically so Arun's doubt is, let me open the doubt for you all. Sir, in the example you gave for finding key 53 from node A using chord rings and finger table, yes, how do you know that we need to take 6 bits? And from what I found from internet, we need to do node plus 2 power I mod 2m. Of course, this formula is not a fixed formula. Different authors may use different things. From where can we deduce what m is, sir? Okay, that is the question. So let me open that slides for you, the one, the DHT which I have shown to you. I'll come from the slides what I have discussed here. If you observe this distributed hash table video, then the explanation is there. Try to follow it, but a little bit of computation is here. So of course, many of you might have understood what is a hashing technique. What does in hashing will help us? So basically, hashing will help us for the searching process in a more convenient and a more easy manner and a more efficient manner. So if you are storing your data in your tables like this on the left side, you do some hashing on a particular attribute and you try to perform some hashing. Hashing is basically simple terms for those people. It is like replacing this set of characters with some set of numbers. But there is a formula to have that kind of replacement. So that is what your A is been transformed to 8965455. BB is transformed. Some names are been translated or transformed. Basically, they're getting changed to another particular name, a set of numbers instead of characters. So when you are trying to store this, it will be storing in terms of your key. That is what your key, that the key is basically this set of values. These are keys, and the corresponding to each key, there is a corresponding value. Corresponding means related value here. So for each key, there is a related value. Of course, the keys are going to be unique. So you are going to maintain this key value pairs. That's what we call it as. These key value pairs are distributed among the peers. Peers means among the computers, which are acting like the same properties. They are not like client and server. They are having the equal rights. They are, each one of them is able to serve, each one of them is able to ask. So both those peer systems are connected in a network. That's why you call it as peers. Now, that data is going to be shared among them. So in order to understand that one, assume that there are 64 computers are connected with each other. Each computer is being designated with an ID number. So that ID numbers from 0 to 63. So each computer is having one ID number. Now, all the 64 computers will not always be there. Always be there means always active. They are not going to be there. Sometimes one computer, today your computer is given an ID number, that computer may be shut down, or it is not active, or it is not participating in the network for exchange of data. So suppose there are 8 peers. Among this, totally 64 are there. Assume that there are 64 computers. Overall, there are existing 64 computers. But among these 64, you have only at a particular time 8 peers. Those ID numbers are 1, 12, 13, 25, 32, 40, 48, 60. These are basically your ID numbers. Means 8 computers are now active. Active means they are now connected with each other and try to exchange some information. Now, what exactly is this key 51? Because 60 is there here, which is active, this 60th computer, that is 60th ID computer, will keep track of the other computer informations too. Like 51 is assigned to 60, 60 is assigned to 60 only. Of course, we have another 61 because there are totally 63. Now it is in a circular manner because you are applying the mod operation. Obviously, it goes to the next level or a next ID computer. So that's what you can see. This assume that these 12, 13, 25, 32, 40, 48, 60. So these are circular. That's why they are peers. These are peers which are connected with each other. Now what happens is when you are in the at node number 12, that is your computer number 12, and you like to find out what is the value associated with the key number 53? So there is a value which is associated with 53. You want to find out, but you are now standing or you are now using a system number 12. You don't know what is the value which is related to the key 53. In order to find out the value related to the key 53, but you need to find out where 53 is existing among these live nodes, among these computers which are now connected at that particular instance of time. So now, how do you find that 53 is basically associated to which particular ID. So this, you know that this is the property which you are going to be following here. That's what you call it as key value, which is the convention. The old convention is that the closest is the immediate successor of the key. So the node which is very closest to that particular key is going to be that particular item is going to be falling into that. So because 53 is very much near to your 60, definitely 53 is going to be located at the system number 60. But how that information is been known to system number 12? System number 12 notes the immediate successor is 13. System number 12 only knows that my immediate successor is 13, so he will talk to 13 and find out whether what is the value of 53. But 13 also doesn't know the value of 53 because 53's information is not available with system number 13. So again, that request or that message is again passed to the successor of 13. The successor of 13 is 25. Again, once the request comes to 25, then 25 will check for whether 53 is related to them or 53 is assigned to 25. So obviously it is not assigned to 25. Then again, the request or the message is passed on to the next successor of 25. The next successor of 25 is 32. So similarly, again, 32 checks whether it is 53 is associated with it. No. Then again, the request is again passed to the next successor of 32. The next successor of 32 is 40 here. So the request again comes to 40. Then you will check whether 53 is associated with itself. No. Then the request message, that is only the message. The request message again is forwarded to the next successor of 40. Again, it comes to 48. So again, when it comes to 48, whether the 53 is associated with 48? No. Then the next successor of 48 is 60, according to the live nodes which are active in that particular network at that particular instance. So now 60 has got associated with 53 because 53 is the number 53 has been stored in this particular 60th node. The corresponding value of that 53 is known to 60. And that particular information is going passed on to from where the original message has been initiated. That particular information is going to be known to 60, then that response is being sent to 12. But during this process, during this entire process, if you see the number of messages that are getting exchanged, so 12 to 13 is one message, 13 to 25 is second message, 25 to 32 is another third message, fourth message, fifth message, and sixth message. So here in this case, with this many number of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 peers, if you want to find out a particular value associated to a particular node, if it is in the worst case, you are going to have six messages here. Assume that in a network, there are thousands of computers, thousands of networking devices, the routers or the switches or your other networking elements which are there in your network, which are peers with each other, which are called as peer network is there. So unnecessarily, there is a lot of thousands of computers or thousands of electronic devices are getting exchanged this information. Unnecessarily, that exchange of information takes a lot of time here. So in this small example, there are six messages to get that particular value of 53. But assuming if there a network is containing several thousands of machines, then obviously the number of messages will be more in number. So this particular conventionally that circular DHT method has got a drawback. If you go going to have more number of devices, then more message exchanges will be there and more time will be taken, more delay will be there in transferring the data from one node to the other node. So remember, this is not like client server. They are all peers. They are all equals. But the purpose of peer network is different. The purpose of client server network is different. That's what we discussed in the last class. So this we are discussing in the peer network. This is one of the disadvantages of the peer network, because if the more number of nodes are there, like overlay networks, then obviously more number of messages will be transmitted among themselves and more delay, more transmission cost will be there. To overcome this particular problem, this distributed hash table technique they have incorporated something like, how do you make those things very faster? How do you exchange that files to be faster? Because by this order, if there are n number of nodes, definitely it will be the worst case time will be of big O of n. The big O of n time will be taken for this. So that will be big O of n will be the worst case time. That's why the peer networking has got a drawback. In order to improve this one, now people have projected this quad ring type. That is a technique called as quad ring to speed up the lookup. That is what lookup means, search particular key where it is located in the peer network. So here I have clearly told that m is equal to number of bits in the key or node identifiers. That's what the Arun question is. Basically, from where can we deduce what M is? So M can be the number of bits in the key or the node identifiers. Suppose here in this, the example which you have taken here, how many nodes are there here? So node 8, node 13, node 29, node 37, 46, 51, and 57. These are numbers only. The maximum number that you get it is 57. It means basically you are having from 0 to 63 in terms of powers of 2. So when you see 0 to 63, it means basically this particular example which is being considered here. So I have made it here, totally number of IDs are 64 here. And among those 64, in this particular example, at present you have only, these are active nodes. Active means there are live nodes here, 8, 13, 29, 37, 46, 51, and 57. So what is 64? 64 is equal to 2 power how much? Anyone?
2 power 6, sir.
So 2 power 6, 2 power, it depends on what is that you are going to consider there. So here, this is, if you see each node, what exactly happens in the scalable lookup is each node maintains a routing table, a simple routing table. Routing table means a route where means you need to send the next packet or a packet to be sent to a next node. That's called a table. So each node maintains a routing table, but that routing table has got some information here. So what is that information here? So this is when you are at the node 8, the next successor will be plus 1, that is 2 power 0. This is 2 power 0 is 1, 2 power 1 is 2, 2 power 2 is 4, 2 power 3 is 8, 2 power 4 is 16, 2 power 5 is 32. So totally how many bits you have been using here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bits here. So if you are using that particular 64, 64, 0 to 63, total number of nodes, that becomes, that is not given by me. It is given here only. These are the number of node identifiers. If you see node identifiers, how many node identifiers are there? The number of node identifiers are 64. That comes from your, the number of bits that are, the number of bits that are required to represent that many number of node identifiers. So don't confuse between the statement. It is what the author has given here. Number of bits in the key. If you can, in the key means, suppose 53 you are considering. So how many bits you are going to be required here? So that depends on this here. That's why he has given that the, so here in this case what happens is, if you want to find out the key value which is related to node 57, if you go the conventional way, you have to send from 8 to 13 1, 13 to 29 2, 29 to 37 3, 37 to 46 4, 46 to 51 5, 51 to 57 6. Instead of six messages, now you are reducing to, see here carefully, so node 8. So you're looking for what? You're looking for something like node 57. So you are going to get directly your node 8, you're going to get it to your node 40, node 8 plus 32. That is what you're going to get the number of 64. So that is, it is equivalent to, the next immediate node for node 8 is 46 instead of 13. Like that, the successor node is being changed from this. So this is 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3, 2 power 4, 2 power 5. 2 power 5 is going to be the maximum here. So here, immediate successor node for node 8 is 32. You're reducing all these messages here. You're coming to 46. And if you're looking for 57, so this is the key number 53. Obviously, 53 is located at 57 here. That's why you are jumping, means you're skipping, in other terms, all these intermediate messages can be skipped. And so now with three messages, you can now reach to your the node key value 53. So this is one of the scalable techniques to improve the lookup mechanism, the speed up the process. So related to this particular problem, means this, if you understood here carefully, one similar question was given in the quiz. So try to understand here. This is basically the formula is given here. So M is equal to the number of 6 here. You can see the immediate successor. The successor will be the node N, in small n indicates the node 8, N plus 2 power I minus 1. So your ith is the entry, ith entry in the table, that is the fifth entry in the table. So 2 power 5 minus 1 plus node 8 gives the immediate successor. You know what is an arithmetic modulo? So the arithmetic modulo is basically your 2 power M indicates the number of bits, the maximum number of bits required. Maximum number of bits required for you to identify the corresponding node. I hope you understood it.
Yeah, he is not there. Can you share? Give me the screen. I also have to answer one of these questions.
Sorry, I'm giving back. So,
okay, you are seeing my screen, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. So what he asks is something like this. In the case of forwarding proxies, okay, the proxy disguises the IP address of the client and sends the request to the demanded web server. Okay, that's correct. So that means like the client knows the actual IP address of the server. Okay, so this statement is clear. So in the case of reverse proxy, does this mean that the IP address of the web server is disguised and the web server knows the actual IP address of the client? IP address is okay. So, and the web server knows the actual IP address of the client, whereas the client doesn't. It is approximately okay. I mean, like you can think like that one, but the purpose of the two are different. Okay, let me try to answer it very simply. The idea of the proxy is, so basically, like assume like this is University of Hyderabad network. Okay, so all the computers here, and then wait. You are not seeing my video. Okay, right. Anyhow, you are all hearing me. Okay, so the basic point is, so if it is University of Hyderabad network, University of Hyderabad can restrict like whatever the things, whatever the web pages which can be viewed or not. So basically, like this is a governing agency. So in that sense, all the requests can come to the proxy, and the proxy will only send some of the requests. Okay, some of the requests it will kill. Because like say, for example, if certain content is not to be viewed, it will kill. At the same time, it actually knows like whether it came from a computer or from a mobile or something like that. And based on that, it will give additional information to the server so that the server can adapt the content as per the client. So that's the basic idea of the proxy. Whereas when you think in terms of reverse proxy, the reverse proxy idea is not to hide the client from the server. Its purpose is something different. Say for example, one of the main ideas is, say for example, the reverse proxy can act as a load balancer. Say for example, last week, like we have seen, like Google has so many node servers, isn't it? We all have seen with the tick command. So that means like Google has several servers. Now think about like Google has thousands of servers, some in Latin America, some in Central America, some in Asia, some in Europe. So basically, like whatever the request which is coming from India has to go to a Google application server, which is within somewhere closer to India. Then you may get the response something quick. If a request comes from University of Hyderabad for google.com, and if somehow like the request goes to a Google application server, which is in Latin America, then it will be meaningless, isn't it? So the idea of that reverse proxy in that sense is to basically load balance the load in such a way that the client will be routed to the nearest server. It was never intended like the server's IP is actually hidden from the client. If the client is so curious about learning it, now we have the dig command, isn't it? Using the dig command, he can actually trace his request, and he can actually get the IP address from where exactly he got the response for that request. You see? So it is never intended to hide. Of course, you can think like it is hidden from him, because like the client doesn't know like whether his request will go to this server or this server. It is not known to him. The reverse proxy will hide that information for him. But the purpose of it is not hiding, but rather helping the client. Okay, so that like the request can scale and he can get the response quickly. That's the basic idea. So in some sense, the answer to his question is yes, but it needs a little bit more explanation in terms of the context. So I give both the answers, okay, so that people who are interested can get a little bit more from it. Thank you. Any other questions?
Yeah, I think MCA students are very less in number today.
Yeah, anyhow, if you don't have many questions, like, we are still around, okay, to help you if you have any questions. Okay, please view through the slides, view through the videos, and keep learning.
So integrated MTech students, I think there are many here at this moment, right? So let me just give you an idea about the lab exercises. See, the lab exercises were posted, of course, today only. In fact, very shortly it was posted. So you can start seeing this. So there are two contents here. One is related to HTML, CSS, JavaScript DOM. This is basically the practice session. To understand this, of course, these are direct outputs. I kept it here. You cannot get the source code here. So these are all different exercises only. If at all, you cannot go through different textbooks, but at least you try to practice what exactly each tag is going to do and what are the corresponding attributes and as well as the other configuration parameters for each attribute. So here, this is a form designing, a simple different elements are there, like simple email you can design. One of the exercises also on the email. So these are the things which you can practice. So of course, if those people who are not very much aware of this web HTML programming, if they are beginners, so I suggest all the beginners, please try to practice each one of the problem. Do not leave any problem here. So when you're practicing, just don't simply copy paste. You have to understand what has been written in each line and what it goes on. So like this, please practice every problem that is given here. It is a lot, only problems only, only programs. These are all programs. Do not worry. These are all executed on my laptop, and it will be executed on your laptop also. Suppose one or two problems are there, then let me know if there is any problem. But most likely they are going to be executed. So understand the logic behind in designing the web pages with the various. So JavaScripts, you are going to write programs here. So practice on how do you write the programs using functions. That's what you can see the video lessons and my slides. How do you use arrays here with your JavaScripts? Similarly, you need to understand the document.write document. Who is this row Redis? I think some other name here, RoReady. Okay, anyway. So here, please do practice. All the practice problems are given to you here. Once you practice this thing, now you please go to the exercises. So the exercises here is, let me show you the what is that all about. Let me explain to you. So these are all related to HTML, CSS, JS, and your DOM features have to be incorporated. So simple web pages that includes your timetable preparations, that includes some user interactivity. So your different elements are to be practiced with CSS. How do you design? So I don't want frame. Frame is a very olden topic, and I know it is outdated place. Don't use frame formats. I clearly mentioned using CSS only. So use CSS features for you to design your web pages. Then there is a customer form. How do you create form and form validation? How do you do the validations? Validation, not null, correct format for email. So you need to use regular expressions here, please. Number of digits for phone number, number of characters and other features. All these form validations are to be incorporated in this example. Similarly, you need to perform an online registration form for conducting an international seminar. Just one web page, one or two web pages with navigations. You can, using the anchor tag, you can navigate from one web page to another web page. Similarly, you need to design an email. So please, all of you, I expect every one of you to design an email so that when you complete your PHP and MySQL, you can perform the actual email send. So and again, that email contains from and to values. Please design it properly. So you can use all these things. You can use JavaScript also, of course, as well as you can print your calendar month. So here for this calendar month, it is not very simple. So here we are going to have different set of JavaScript functions for a different set of values. So please understand this assignment is very important for us. So if you, once you build up your skills properly here, so I'm sure that you will be doing good for the rest of the technologies. It will be easy. So if you, anybody is having doubts, you can, of course, what is that the trend, what I have observed here is the doubts related to this assignment will be asked in the next week. So that's what I could see from you people. Anyway, nevertheless, just to have an idea, I have just given you that information. And of course, you are submitting that assignment as a single file, like an assignment, as a PDF file only. I have given the instructions here. Read the instructions carefully. So the instructions, okay, if you want me to open, one second, I open. The instructions is something like this. So the instructions are, please put your comments for each line of code, and as well as the scripts what you have written on your own. So in the comments line, you have to explain the logic. So that logic is going to be whatever you have written. It should not be copied from one person to another person. So it is going to, you have to express the logics there. So if the comments are not there, that question is not going to be evaluated for that assignment problem. Please be aware of this one. So you need to write the comments for each line of the code that you are writing here. Of course, this is a combined assignment. It is a combined assignment. Later, we are going to give the individual assignments that I'll come back to the case studies. Once we complete the second unit, we will go for the case studies. So at present, please, those people who are submitting those assignments, you have to put the comments. And you also assume the relevant data. If suppose you want to put some pictures, if you want to put some other elements on your web page apart from the one which is requested in the questions, you are welcome. You can use your own things. Own features and own images and own formattings. If the formattings are not mentioned here, you can use it. So design your web pages. Definitely these web pages will be useful for you in the later stage of your coursework. So more or less, we are going to use these things for the next set of other technologies to be used here. So that is what I would like to just share some information to you at this moment. Yeah, any doubts here, please? Sorry, I think I muted my mic. So what I was trying to say is we are keep monitoring the students who are viewing the contents and who are doing the activities. So I could see that the last 5-4 days, only a couple of students are not viewing the contents. So please make sure that you please read the videos, the materials properly, see the videos completely. The videos, what we are, maybe I'm observing is that only 5 to 10 minutes of things you are seeing the video. So please see the video completely and read the materials completely. So once, if you read those materials and even if the videos are very boring, please I urge you to understand the complete video, means the contents that has been presented in the video completely. So don't stop the viewing in the between only. So until unless you don't view the video contents completely, you may not be able to get some understanding of that particular topic or of that particular activity. So keep viewing the videos completely, read the materials completely, all the slides, once or twice. Then if you cannot get into it twice, please ask us, query us. The more you query us, then obviously you are going to extract more information from us. That will be more benefit for you. So now already we have entered into the third week. So days will go fastly. Definitely time will be running up and it will be time will be very much short in the later part of our coming days, because you'll be engaged with so many other activities related to the courses. So you need to properly plan, properly balance your activities, and definitely you're going to excel it. Any other doubts? One more request has come from the DBMS sir. Basically, sir would like to take the class from 4 to 5 on Monday. So I think sir, he has some problems. So he has requested me for this over phone. Then I thought, I said to him that I will talk to you all people, and based on your concern only, we can try to reschedule our interactions. So if sir is going to take 4 to 5, is it okay for you all to have a session from 5 to 7? If you accept only, then we can put forward the request to the department again. Otherwise,
I remember we had to really go through a lot of hierarchy to get it from 6 to 8 to 4 to 6, okay?
Actually, the sir was there is a request come from sir.
Yeah. That's why, so if all of them agree, then we have to go with that hierarchical discussion. So we need very clear consent from you guys before we talk. Let us put it something like this. If we have the session from 5 to 7, who has objections?
Actually, has told the second option. That's what he said to me. This is your second option. The second option is, if for us it is not possible to shift from 4 to 5, then he said that he will conduct the class on Tuesday 2 to 3. But he has put, he has informed me this as a second option. But he wants me to tell about the first option, what he prefers to have that first option. In the worst case, he is going to have that for you, the DBMS class on Tuesday only. But he said that I said that it all depends on the students. So I said I will talk to them today and I will update him accordingly.
So exactly, let me try to put the question in simple terms. Yes or no questions are easy, always, isn't it? So who has objections if we move our sessions from the current timing to 5 to 7? Which of you have objections? If nobody raises a hand, then we think like there is no objections. It's an S, no question, simple. Which of you have objections if we move our session from 5 to 7? Please.
I'll tell you, they may not express it. See, 4 to 5 is a DBMS, again 5 to 7 will be internet technologies. It is a continuous 3 hours will be there. So that you need to, light problem in evening. Mohammed Farfan, Farhan, actually, Fardiyu only, actually, sir.
We reschedule from 4 to 6. And literally, I had to talk with Dean personally to move that 6 to 8 to 4 to 6. Yeah, we can consider your problem, okay? The other one, just me will not help, okay? So if you have any valid reason, please type it, because we have to put all the reasons. We cannot just go and tell the dean or the other professor to say like, no, we don't want to change. But we have to change, like the students don't want to change because, okay, we need reasons, always. So feel free to type. And we also assured you that we will not carry the reasons with the names, okay? So we'll keep it anonymous. Trust us for that.
Actually, MCS students are very active, sir, but nowadays I'm not seeing them participating in our discussions. I don't know.
Usually they are active, okay.
Integrated MTech students, yes, of course, they are more or less there participating in our discussions. That's what I don't know what is happening to MCS students.
Yeah, once again, that's a serious request, okay, in lighter terms. If you have any problems for that moment, make your reasons, okay? We'll carry on that information. Otherwise, we have to give in. Because, like, the problem is, like, our original schedule was from 6 to 8. Remember that. Our original schedule was from 6 to 8. After a lot of requests, like we switched to 4 to 6. But then, like, since we switched to 4 to 6, like others also find it problematic. So they will come with their own request. And we have to give valid reasons if we deny them. Okay. That's why we are requesting. Yes, Sagiruddin's response is a valid response. Okay, so that is the reason why, like, we actually shifted to 4 to 6. Yeah, you can go for that recorded video, that's okay. But then, like, generally from my experience, what I can tell is, if a lecture is recorded, you can view. Okay. If a asynchronous video is recorded, you can view, because you know that the content is there and you are waiting for it, you can get it. But a discussion, if you view a recorded video, you don't know like when the people will be talking, okay? So you have to skip, and then see like, okay, something interesting is coming. Okay? Of course, we are recording and we are putting it online, but eventually, my sincere understanding is, recording of these sort of general discussion sessions will not help that much. People can't focus for 2 hours, okay, where most of the party is silent, and something interesting is popping up all of a sudden, okay? But okay, there is no other means, there is no other solution, then it's okay. But approximately, Sagiruddin is okay if we really move from not to 6 to 8, but 5 to 7. That I got. And I see Mohammed Farhan saying like he has a problem. Can you be a little bit more detailed? Okay. So basically, like, if from the current answers, what we can feel is like, if the whole institute basically pressures us to move from 5 to 7, yeah, please, thank you. Then we don't have any serious reasons to basically not to do it. Okay. Nagendra, you can consider it like that.
Sorry, sir.
So basically, from this discussion, what it appears is like, if the whole institute insists that we should move from 5 to 7, now we don't have any strong reason or like strong argument to be able to say no to it. Okay.
So we'll go with the 4 to 6 only, sir. That's what.
We will go with 5 to 7.
We'll go with 5 to 7, huh?
Yeah, because see, that also like if the institute also pressures us, okay. So Digambar has asked you, Professor Digambar.
Yeah.
And the dean also says like you guys basically move to 5 to 7. Then right now, from the current arguments, we don't have any strong case or argument to say no to that request. So then we have to move 5 to 7.
Anyway, we'll update you based on our discussions, and definitely we'll update you by the coming Saturday or Sunday for the Monday session. So if there is having any concern for anybody, please let us know before Saturday. So please think over it, just because some internet connectivity and other issues are there with this, sir. Yeah. Yeah, any other doubts related to the subject? Yeah. Yeah, Saiteja, are you online?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, what did you means? How did you feel that our first week and second week sessions?
It was good.
Are you able to follow the video lessons and the material what we are giving?
Yeah, completely.
Yeah. So let me just ask one by one. I'm not just pointing to only one of them, if you don't mind. Just to make sure that at least, you know, be frank and be positive. We'll take positive only. So do not worry about that. So we want to improve. That's what we want to make sure that you gain the knowledge. So Amrutam, so I'll just go by one by one. It is not in a specific order. What the names I'm seeing on my screen, I'm just trying to call you. That's the only thing. Amruta, are you online?
Yes, sir.
How do you feel about means? What is your feeling about the first 2 weeks? So how do we can improve further? In what way we can improve? Just if you in your own terms, please.
So far, I have understood everything, sir, in the classes. Just sir, in your videos, if you could speak a little louder, it would help.
Yeah, my mic issue is there. Even my voice is also low. Somehow, of course, in the classroom, I usually. Put more energy into my voice, but because we are now I'm talking to the computer, logically my voice is not coming out because I'm just seeing my face only on the screen. So that is the thing. Anyway, I'll try to improve my voice. Yeah.
Fine. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Any other things?
No, sir.
Yeah. Lakmalanji, are you online?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, how are you, Lakmalanji?
Sir?
How are you?
Fine, sir.
So, have you seen the materials? Have you read the materials of the first 2 weeks? And have you seen the videos?
Actually, I was suffering fever, sir. So, I was in
Those videos and materials are there on the our Moodle website only. So whenever it is comfortable for you, please go through them. Okay. And you need to ask questions to me.
Okay.
I'm worried about. I'm little bit worried about you only, basically. To be very frank. Okay. So.
Okay.
Yeah. Don't worry about. Not unable to understand. Just let me know. So we'll see what is the other alternative to explain to you. But you have to at least read once the material. Once you read it and write down the points, whatever you are not able to understand, you can ask like this or you can send me mail personally or whatever you like to have. Okay? Yeah. Riya, are you online, please? Are you online?
Yes, sir.
So, what is your feeling? I mean, what is your impression or what is your observation on the first 2 weeks?
Sir, it's good. The contents are also good. I followed all the contents.
So now this from this week onwards, I'm just informing to all others also. You have now complete set of practicals are coming.
To do some practice on HTML, CSS, JavaScript.
Yes.
That's why if you provide lab questions to me also, then it would.
It is there. See, now that's what I told you in the beginning of this session. Now MCS students also have the material, the lab exercises, and as well as the sample codes and the practice material is available. Have you not seen those materials here, which I put it on the website?
No, sir. I haven't seen that.
Let me just show you once here now only. Just hold on. See, if you go to our course page, see here.
Is it in week third?
Sorry, is it in?
Week third?
Yeah, week three. This is week three. Today onwards, we are in the week three.
So that's why I haven't seen it.
Okay. So see, that's what every week we are going to post the things. This first 2 weeks is related to first unit. The first unit is on the application layer protocols, basically.
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, now our actual HTML, CSS, now the videos are there. Sir videos are there, we are divided the topics, actually. So you can see our videos as well as the materials and the slides here. So here at the bottom, I have kept it some sample codes for practice. There are more than 50 programs are there. More than 50. Only HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Around 94 pages are there with code and with the outputs. So that's what I told you. Every one of you, please practice this HTML, CSS, JavaScript. If these three are perfect for you, if you understood these three, HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, JavaScript is the most important thing for you all, I'm telling you. So practice it. If you do on your own, you'll get more knowledge. So along with this, assignment three is also there. Some exercises. Basically, these exercises are for integrated MTech. For you, it is like an assignment for MCS students. So that's what, from this week onwards, you will see a lot of practice has to be done. You need a lot of time to do on your systems. If you cannot do this on your laptop, you need to have your browser and editor. And if you don't have it, you have other sources, like you can do it on the Moodle server, or you can use any other web resources are there. Other websites also, you can run HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So wherever you like to do, you practice it. Whichever is convenient for you, you practice it. If you do it on your own laptop, that will be most convenient and the most best one. Okay?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Shruti, I'm just calling by names here, which are in my screen order. So, Shruti, are you online? Shruti, integrated MTech student, Shruti, please. I think she's not online. Okay, let me go to the next.
I'm online. I sent a text message.
Yes. Sorry. Just we like to hear from you. What is your observation on this first 2 weeks? So how do you cope up with those materials, the video lessons, and the materials what we are posting. Of course, this is not as equivalent to the classroom teaching, but we like to hear from you if you have to improve for ourselves. Like one of them has said, my voice has to be a little bit increased. Apart from that, is there any other things that you like to share with us? Shruti, again you are offline again. No? No, sir. I'm comfortable with the classes are so far. So please, you have to do practice. From now onwards, see HTML, CSS, rigorous practice is required. Of course, the first 2 weeks we have just given one assignment. So the rigorous practice means more exercises has to be done. You can see I have put a lot of exercises there for you. Of course, the very small exercises these are to build some ideas and to have some design thinking and as well as the development of the web pages. So I hope you will do these problems. Any doubts, please let us know. Yeah. Rakesh? Rakesh Reddy.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please. Are you online?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Very good. So how things are going on for you now? So are you able to follow our materials and these things, and are you able to understand it?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So what is your any comments or suggestions from your side?
Nothing as such.
Nothing as such. But you want to say something, you can say, well, no problem. So I expect from you also, because I know every one of you more or less, if I can recollect you from the last year, the last semester, sorry. So, but still, yeah, especially you also, you are one of them, you do a lot of practice, Rakesh. Okay? So from this week onwards, you need to put more efforts for your practice or the programming. All right? Is it all right?
Yes,
yeah, all the best. Yeah. Neeraj? Neeraj Vivek, MCS student, please. Neeraj, yes. So, okay, you are unable to talk. Anyway, it's fine. So, what is your observation and what do you find? How do you think that we are going on? All are good, sir. So, but Neeraj, see, I'm able to recollect you from the lab sessions which you had interactions. So Neeraj, you need to improve a lot and please start doing practice from now onwards seriously. Okay, so exercises are given, materials are given, very simple things. These are HTML is very, very simple nowadays, but it looks very interesting for you all. You can design your own web pages in the later stages. So start doing from now onwards. All the best. Yeah, okay. So Shriyansh.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Shriyansh Rathore. Yeah, how are you?
Fine, sir.
Very good. So, how is your study going on now?
Sir, it's good, but we are still waiting for the university open.
Yeah, university open, a lot of uncertainty is there now. Yeah, so because we are all facing the tough situations. So, please do not wait for that. No need to wait. So, don't waste. It means the time will go off. Time will just run away from your hands.
Definitely, sir.
Yeah, so just make use of the time. Whatever you best you can do, try to utilize all the time and try to put all your efforts as much as you can. So
sure,
don't want to pressurize you, but still, but don't lose this time. At least every day, one exercise. That's what, if you see my exercises, I have given you 15 days time and 10 exercises are there. Even if you study all this week, the next week also, if you start, you will be able to complete it within 15 days. At least one exercise, one day, at least everybody has to do. Every day, at least one or two exercises has to be done. So that it will be something like you, for you to get something practiced. So do not lose those focus and make yourself in the problem. Once the time is flying away, once the time is gone, then you will not get it back. So that is fine. Yeah, Ashaswini. Yeah, all the best. Yeah. Ashaswini, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Good. So, how things are going on for you now?
It's good, sir.
Good. So, you are also one of the hardworking students I can observe the last semester interactions. But, so, have you started practicing on this HTML, CSS? Of course, today we have kept it.
Yes. Yeah. No, sir, I did not start it.
You did not start. What about the last 2 weeks?
Yes, sir, I completed it.
Completed. But are you able to understand? Are you able to follow those materials and the things that you are?
Yes, sir, I'm able to follow.
Yeah. So please, you are a regular student, I know it, but just a caution for you, you need to do every day some activity. Okay. Okay, all the best. Yash Rastogi, Yash, MCA student, Yash, how are you? Yash Rastogi, are you there? Yes, sir. Yeah. So how things are going on with you? How your studies are going on? Yash Rastogi? Yash Rastogi, yeah, you are attending the sessions regularly. I can observe that. Study doing very well, sir. Yes, so yes, put little more efforts. That's what I feel from you, from my last interaction with you. So you have to keep on your toes all the time. Means you need to be every day you need to do some exercises which are related to our programming. So you will definitely excel in that one. So start doing everyday exercises for you. So are there any difficulties for the last 2 weeks sessions, materials, or for the way you are to understand, the way you are to follow? No, sir. Yeah, just, but yeah. So we go, I think myself and sir will go in the same type. Of course, I'll increase my voice a little bit. We'll go the same speed with the same contents and so on. Let us see how things goes on after another 2 weeks. So Ashaswini Rupa.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So how your study going on now?
Everything is good, sir.
Good, good. So you are also one of the hardworking students. So yeah, but what about the last 2 week sessions? How did you feel about that?
Everything is good, sir. I was able to follow everything.
Okay, good, good, good. So keep the same pace, keep your efforts, keep going on with all your efforts like this. So the things will be fruitful in the later stage. Don't worry. So any doubts are there, please let us know. Okay?
Yeah. Okay, sir.
Take care. Bye. And did I miss anybody here? Pawan Kumar. Pawan Kumar, are you online?
Yes, sir.
So how are you?
Fine, sir.
Sometimes you are there in the session, sometimes you are not there. So what is the reason for you to join late today?
Some power problem.
What happened?
Charging is not available
on your mobile phone. But so are you able to browse our materials properly on the Moodle, from the Moodle website?
Yes, sir.
Very good. So at your own pace only you can try to browse it and try to understand it. So how is your understanding going on with the materials?
Fine, sir. Now.
So far it is okay. Okay. So if you're able to understand the first unit materials properly, then the other all units also will be in the similar way. Only we go with the same type of delivery contents. So hopefully we'll try to do some justice for this.
You are scaring people in the background, like all the Vishal people are running away. See,
they don't want to disperse. What is they are hearing? We are not going to harm them in any way. Let us also know what is their
objective. That's okay. But let's ask them an open question, okay? So the idea is, like, if they have any issues, okay, they can write us. Let them write. Okay. That's far better. So ever since, like, you started asking the questions, I was just trying to observe the numbers. All of a sudden, they dropped from 28 to 16.
They don't want to mess with this. Let it be, sir. No problem.
Okay. Hello, sir.
Yeah, please. Who is
sir,
this?
Yes, Tarun, tell me. Tarun.
We have assignments for course theory course and lab course as well, no sir?
No. For integrated MTech students, because there is a lab component for you. I told clearly this in the last week also. Integrated MTech, once again, I'm repeating. Integrated MTech students, we need not submit assignments. Your assignments are equivalent to your lab exercises. We don't want to give, again, those exercises or another set of exercises. You will not find time for you for that.
Yes.
Yeah. The last 2 weeks, because we did not started the practicals, the last 2 weeks, we have given as an assignment to you.
Oh.
See, the assignment is for MCA students because they are not doing the practical. See, ultimately, both MCA and MT, integrated MTech students, they have to do practice. If you look to the logical statement of that one, basically, they have to do practice because the officially MCA students do not have the lab component. The lab course is not there for them. So the lab, because the lab component is not there, we cannot avoid like that because it is, this is a basically a practice course. So we are making the MCA students also to do the practice. Now, if you can do this 10 problems in 1 week or at the maximum within 10 days, that is well and good. You'll definitely excel in that one. So I can assure you that if you go in the same speed, we'll do many number of exercises for every week. For every 10 days, you will see 10 exercises will be there.
Yes, sir.
So you have to do every week at least. Miss, I have given the time up to 2 weeks because some people may have some issues with their systems and all those things. That's why we have to keep the buffer period for that. So if you can complete by 10 days or 1 week, that is well and good. There is no harm here. So, but please make sure you are doing on your own. Even if you copy from the internet also, it's not a problem. But what I expect is, you may not get the complete solution for what we have asked there. You may not get the exact solution from the internet, that is for sure. So there are some things which have changed. So you need to put your own things on that particular problem, for every problem, more or less. So exact solution, you'll not get it from the internet. There is a change in there. Along with that, what is another thing that you expect is for the lines of code what you have written, you have to write the comments. That comments are nothing but the what is the logic for the next following lines that you have written in the program. So we will read the comments for your submissions of your exercises for your integrated MTech as well as for MCA students.
So for the theory course, the evaluating component is only quizzes, sir.
Theory component, the evaluating component for what
is only there are no assignments.
I agree. There is no assignment for you. There is no assignments for integrated MTech students. Only your quizzes. But the first two assignments will be counted for the.
Okay.
So how many number of quizzes will be counted? How many number of assignments will be counted? I told you in the introduction class that we'll make a decision in the later stage of our semester. I cannot assure you at this moment, but we go with the average or we go with the some number of quizzes and some number of assignments that we will see it in the later stage. If you tell now only, then what happens is you are going to skip those things, or if you are going to take something like that. That's why we want you to first in the initial stage, everyone should try to follow certain things. That later, because if the marks are less for one of the some of the quizzes or some of the assignments, then we can ignore that and make a calculation in the later stage. That form I will tell you later. You don't worry about it at this moment. Anyway, that if the form is acceptable for you only, we'll go with that formula. So, how many number of
HTML task given, no sir, the PDF. Oh, in that second question, I have a doubt on that.
HTML task, what is that HTML
assignment 3.
Okay, let me open the file once again.
In the second question, what did you mean by that? User interactive features of table tag, sir.
You have to use a table tag. See, how your table looks like, basically?
It's a table.
A table which consists of rows and columns.
Yeah.
So on the rows, you'll have your courses will be scheduled. So at one left hand side, you'll have the weekdays. On the top, you'll have the hours, and you'll have the corresponding courses. So on each cell of your row and column intersection, you'll have the corresponding course. Are you getting this point?
Yes, sir.
So suppose if the user is going to select on Monday only Monday.
Okay.
Today is Monday. I want to have only today schedule. I don't want to have the other days. If the user is going to select on only on Monday, Monday is a day of the week that will be on a particular cell. So you need to give the complete all the 10 hours of your time schedule, means from 9 to 10 if there is any class, or from 12 to 1 it is a class, that particular row only should be displayed for them.
Okay.
Are you getting this point?
Yes, sir.
If suppose I'm selecting the hours, means on the column side, you will have the hours. Hours means 9 to 10, 10 to 11, 11 to 12, 12 to 1, like this there, right?
Yes, sir.
Right. If I select only a particular hour, suppose 5 to 6, if I'm going to select, so on all weekdays, on 5 to 6, what is that the schedule which you have based on the timetable? It means, that's what, if you see the table tags for the rows and columns, which when they are selected, what to be done, when they are not selected, what to be done, you need to put the appropriate attribute values. You will get the idea. Think about it. Is user interactive. User is interactivity means user is clicking some of those cells. User is going to interact with those table contents. When he is interacting, you need to provide certain information. That's what user interactivity here.
Okay, sir. Got it.
Okay. So go like that, please go. Yeah, now you're good. You are in the week three already, you started.
I logged it just now.
Sir. It's okay. No worries. Yeah. So Tarun, I'd like to hear from you. What is your feeling about the last 2 weeks? Actually, you were not there in my list when I was calling there. Suddenly you appeared again.
No, okay. I was.
Yeah. Anyway, I'd like to hear from you just for one, because sir, I said anyway, you will stop it. But I'd like to hear from you also. What is your observation for the last 2 weeks?
Initially, I thought that there were too many quizzes, but. One quiz, no sir. So later on, since the already 2 weeks are passed by, I got habituated to that, so it's fine now.
Yeah, good. See, always in the beginning, anything that is going to be a new thing will be definitely looks like confusing and problematic and everything. So once you are used to that one, then you'll be there. So we don't want to bother you. That's why we have given only 2 quizzes in this week. So anyway, because we are giving exercises, so we also don't want to make you to work all the time only for this particular course only. No. So we also give sufficient time for you to do those activities properly. So yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Any other things? Yeah.
Most of them already have left. Devender, you are muted.
Another 15 minutes, sir. No problem.
Anyhow, if they have further doubts, let them read it. Okay, so let's not bother them. And since only five of you guys are there, if you have any issues, like, you can write us. Okay, that's easiest way now. There is no point just drawing it till the end, just for the sake of drawing it. Okay.
Robin. Hello.
Robin.
Robin Goyal.
Who is Robin? I see only five of them, and plus you, us two.
No, sir. I just admitted him. A request has come. Just now it has come.
Okay. Right. Let me wait.
I was wondering how come he is joining now. Problem for him.
And probably the moment you call his name, he's off. Okay, come on. Guys, feel free. Keep asking questions. Okay, no problem.